Hello once again, welcome back to The Binding of Isaac, where we search for those elusive last two items. We have a win streak of four, but that's not important. That's not even on purpose, because something's going to happen, like that, just expecting. And we lose it immediately. So we've got the Keeper. I guess we just play our best. Decent amount of damage. Ooh, what did I do there on the Keeper? So at least we can get out of dicey situations. Now, we remember how this works. We obviously can't go to the curse room because we don't have enough HP. HP that does drop will immediately spawn as flies. Which is kind of nice if you find one of those super secret rooms that's full of red HP, but not really anticipating that, let's be honest. This is interesting. Well, I guess it doesn't matter what we could have done with this, because obviously if this had been a run where we wanted to take a deal with the devil. A, no devil deal on this floor, so we couldn't have spent the HP anyway, but also... Oh, you fucking... We're not taking... What am I saying? Even if this had been a run where we wanted to take a deal with the devil, which it's not, we couldn't have done this because the deal with the devil would be on the next floor. But... Worth thinking about. At least it's worth entertaining the idea, you know. You don't just pick something up and go, oh, that's great. You know, double check that it's not something that you're going to benefit from later. I'm pretty upset that I didn't do that at the right time. Not hugely upset. I wouldn't mind small rock, which is why I'm going to explode these for now. Well, the key helps as well. I mean, the more item rooms we can get to, the better we stand. The better a chance we stand. And it's always worth following these, even if it looks like you can nip through. Don't risk it. Trust me. Okay. Go. Run. Right, this guy's going to explode, so make sure we keep away from that. I say guy, of course, in a non-gendered sense. It's just a... Like guy as in the thing that you put on a... Like an effigy. Good. Fist head. We'll get to the shop for free. Which means we have to pay to get into the other one, but it's not a shop, right? Might be worth considering. We'll see what's in it. It could have cards or just something valuable. It not being, in fact, I should have known it's not a shop because it's next to the spawn room. It's got Book of Revelations, which is some flies. We might as well take this and get rid of it just so that it doesn't show up again. Honestly, I don't know what books I expect to be good. It's like there's no book that is decent for the Keeper, I think. I mean, how to jump could be temporarily good as a sort of a flying item. But I don't expect that any real book is long-term valuable. Well, any actual book is real long-term valuable. I just expect that they will always be superseded by the fact that every room you get a 50% chance of having HP. Which, like... The Keeper is unique in that having HP available on every room is extremely useful, because normally you can sort of survive for a while without picking up any more HP. And this is dangerous, because now I've got a Keeper meat, so I'm going to start using it as my orbital, as damage dealing orbital, and then I'll be sad because I walk into things and take damage that I shouldn't be taking. A bottle of pills, which generates a pill, which is... addicted, which I assume does not make any difference to the Keeper because we only have single HP anyway. Right, how do you deal with this? You actually have to slow down in the middle of the room, which is very fuck frightening. We managed it and we got a secret room, which is amazing. Maybe we try and get some money out of these things. We have only got one bomb and we just found it, but... I mean, I guess we got 5 cents, which is all I could have really hoped for. Like, selling your money doesn't even make sense. My brain stopped. It's like, what are you about to say? Just don't say it, because it doesn't make sense. Spending money doesn't matter as the Keeper, right? Only not picking it up is a problem. Or a good idea. Not picking up money is a good idea, because then there's money to heal you, but... You can still spend the money that you picked up. You can't go back and use that as HP. That's a very scary situation. Yes, we definitely want to take that if we can. Which we currently can't. I guess we just keep going and hope that we can get enough money. Oh god, run. The flies did it. How do we get enough money to never have a curse ever again on this entire run? Don't walk into that. How many times do you have to walk into that before you teach yourself not to fucking do it? When Pin does that, his next jump always comes from there. Pro tip. Also, that was extremely scary, and don't do that. We've got to deal with the devil. We could take one. But they're both shit, and I don't want to. Now, regeneration does work. It's worth noting. There's no way of getting the bomb. And I really want a bomb, because we could get into the curse room. Let's keep going, see if this last room has some amazing stuff in it for us. Help. I hate that. Now you can follow this one around super easily. Fuck. I was wrong about that. Let's do another one. You can't follow those around super easily, so don't try and do what I just did there. Honestly, I thought that I was in the right position. I may have been going anti-clockwise when I should have been going clockwise. That would make a lot of sense. But, you know, who expects to beat the keeper, right? There goes our streak, by the way. All four of them. If I'm going to try streaking, I won't do it as... I won't random it. I'll either do it cyclically and assume that I'll never get more than 10. Or, you know, I'll just do Isaac streaks, for example. And we should be able to get all of this. And possibly a secret room. Yes. Now we just need another bomb. Now the secret room's worth going to in and of itself, but... Oh, we did get another bomb. So we can put this here and get into the curse room, which is very rare. And I will actually use the other... Oh, fudge. Key. Bomb. I will use the other bomb to do this rather than blow up those mushrooms. The mushrooms could give us magic mush, but who cares? I care. Magic mush is a really good damage upgrade, but... There was a lot to stand to gain from that, and there's a lot to stand to gain from this as well. This floor's been great for things that require bombs, which is odd, because normally you ain't got shit in terms of bombs, but today we've got plenty in terms of bombs. We haven't picked up any specific upgrades. We're not stronger or anything, but we've got a good position. We're playing from a good position of consumables, so it gives us a good chance to get much better things in future. We should flip this. Oh, a luck upgrade. That's nice. We've already got 10 cents, for example. So if we were to get to our shop and have enough money that we haven't used as HP... I hate these spider webs, though. Of course, all shops are free, so we can always get into them. Keeper doesn't start with that trinket, by the way. I think you get it for beating maybe Boss Rush? But probably Greed Mode. So might as well go into it. 7 cents. That's the wrong candle, though. So, what are you trying to pull? We will go to the item room first. This is cellar one, so it's free. It's actually a terrible item. 2 cents is the best thing that was in that room. Well, there you go. Maybe we can get a quarter. We've got plenty of bombs we should try. Or a shitload of spiders is also fine. I mean... Should use that, too. Oh my god. Well, what happened to my luck upgrade, though? I'm gonna leave and come back. It takes a little bit longer, but who wants to fight spiders? Ain't nobody got time for that. Alright. We flip this. Got our thingy. But if we continue not to get hit, that would also be great. Good. Well done. That worked out really well. We can also use bombs against this haunt. Oh, you shitbag. I honestly thought it would stop against the bomb, but I guess we learned something. Play better. Alright, third time lucky. Next episode, you'll see how much of a win streak in the negatives we have. Let's explode this. Could get small rocks straight away, that would be swell. We didn't. Thanks for playing. Yeah, fire yourself. And I will destroy the fire forthwith. Hagalaz! Probably going to be a bigger room with lots of rocks on it, so I'm okay with this. Does a burning basement have basement semantics, or does it have cellar semantics? Because if it's a basement but on fire, I can dig it. You know what? Expose yourselves. But if it's a shitload of spiders as well, which honestly I should know, but I have not really been paying that much attention, then that's even harder. Why am I lagging? Who's doing what? Are you feeling it, or is it just me? I don't know. Can't tell if it's actually happening or if it's just... Well, we'll carry on. Getting here for free. 15 cents with buyers. There's options, which at this stage is an excellent pickup. Ooh. That's three. Am I doing it right? We haven't picked up anything, so we've obviously not been to the... Okay. Here it is. Oh, that's pretty nice. Some more money. We should shoot things to find money. That's a good idea. It does feel framey. Haha! What an excellent turnout that was. One more cent and we're sorted. Come on, one more cent. I mean, we can get one from the wooden nickel, but we might need to use that for HP, so I'm not going to rely on it. But one more cent before we get to the boss would be amazing. Because then we start the run with those options working for us. Okay, keep shooting the fires though. And honestly, if we get a respawn item, probably going to take it. Because really we're here to find the items that we need for real plat. We're not here to do a streak of keeper runs. That's so silly. Why would anybody do such a thing? Bombs might get us money out of this. Yeah, that's a lot of money actually. We'll go to the shop now. Take a little bit longer than we normally would like to on the first floor, but we've got to give ourselves every advantage that we have as the keeper. And I think that the advantage gained by taking those options at this stage is a really good one. And we could get the blue map as well in a minute. So we'll see. Secret room? Please blow up both rocks. It did blow up both rocks. Phew. I think we'll buy the blue map as well, because secret rooms could also contain some really good stuff, even if it's just a shitload of flies that then, you know, betray us by exploding bomb flies next to us. Obviously, it doesn't help us on this floor, so it's not quite as valuable as those options, which you don't tend to see from, you know, zero state Isaac. Is this where we've been? No. So you don't tend to know that there's options. Puts a question mark on your head, because normally you've picked up some amazing things already by the time you get those options. So first floor, those options is swell. Okay, I was worried. I probably should have been using this way more often, but there you go. The creep from toxic mysterious liquid here is so good against these things. Nothing up there. Could be a secret room, but we don't know because we can't see the map. We'll open this. We'll activate this. Make sure we've got a coin. I'm not really making sure, but at least try our best to have a coin. Wouldn't mind another bomb. Although secret tinted rocks are not that useful to us necessarily. Didn't get one. Small rock would be great. And the tears upgrade from this boss would also be great. It's Monstro. We can avoid Monstro. And it is susceptible to all our creeps, so bring it on, Monstro. Yep, die. Of course, if I hit it with all three of my tears at once, that's also a good idea. I don't really understand the mechanics, the thinking, sort of the lore behind why greed fires out three tears that has a triple shot going on, because he doesn't have a third eye. Not greed, it's the keeper. You understand. Possibly it's simply because the greed heads, the keeper heads, fire two shots, but of course if you were constantly probably this, because it's the same as the other one but with more stuff, the keeper heads fire two shots, but you couldn't have an entire run where you've got the whiz. That would just be shit. Well, you could have an entire run as a challenge run, but you wouldn't want to do it. That took ages, by the way. Should I have done that? Absolutely not, because that was our only key. You want an entire character that was stuck with the whiz shots, would you? You wouldn't, like, are you a wizard is pretty shit. Petrified poop, I think, might actually be better for us, at least at this early stage. I might take the shop key back, but being able to get coins out of poop at a semi-regular basis, and when not coins, flies, sounds decent. Must remember to use this spacebar item, because even if we don't need the HP that it gives us, we can buy stuff with it. So we should. No. Not even going to shoot the fires, it sounds like too much effort. I will shoot the red fire. Oh shit. Okay. Our tier delay is such that it's almost useful to not fire until you specifically want to, so that you can control when you fire. Which is, of course, still gated by a maximum rate, but I would like to get in there, but not being in the burning basement, none of these rocks has been replaced. Oh, we can't get in. No bombs. The recent run that we threw away was doing really well on bombs. This would have been a great opportunity. Where's all our poops, by the way? Promise poop. Kind of threw that one away slightly. Again, can't get the bomb even though it's right there. Pest. Anyone got a bomb? I'm glad you went for the champion because that's actually really helpful. Still no bombs. Very well. Still not using my coin item. Very annoying. Please. Stand next to your explosion. Compared to the recent Maggie run, which I think is the last episode, when everything that happened exploded us in our own face. It seems a little bit rich that the keeper, that the little horn here doesn't even manage to make actual bombs with a sufficient blast radius to blow him up from that distance. Right, I mean, if it's going to be a problem for me, it can at least be a problem for the boss as well. Come on now. Come on now. We don't want to take the deal with the devil. And we can't. It was worth a look. Run. It doesn't matter which one we take, they both suck. I guess we keep going and see if we can find a way into any of this stuff. Got petrified poop, we should shoot the poops. It's not working out for us. So I think our play here is to go back and get the shop key. And then see if we can use that to buy a real key or a bomb and sort of kickstart the whole process. Fair enough. I mean, being able to go into a shop reasonably often is kind of okay. It just doesn't seem that powerful. Petrified poop could give us so many coins. Well, there's no key available. You can buy a bomb and get a key, so it kickstarts itself. We can get one coin here. I'm probably not going to go for this tinted drop, because I can't, and also there's one in here. I mean, I can, but I might as well go for this one. And I'm not going to be able to get the... Oh, what? Well, I won't open that. I'll open the item room. Still, this, the game is not making it easy on me to get anything under me. You know, anything under my wings. Any wind in my sails. Oh, it was all that for fucking Ghost Baby. Fine. You can join. What's the other item? There's another trinket miles away, and I've no idea what it is, because it's been such a long time that my memory's gone. Could have bought that card. It was a playing card, but it could also have been shit, so who cares? Now, knowing me, I'm going to do really well on this run and cause it to be a super long episode, but we'll see. You open. Open. Good. Why are you not taking creep damage? Are you immune to poison? Is that a thing in this game? Didn't use my coin, did I? Walk into room, use coin. Avoid flies. I'm glad I don't have any of my own right now. Man, you really need to get a chain reaction going on. Whew, that was close. Because you don't want to have to fight them one by one like I am doing, because it takes forever and it's so much more dangerous. Plus, we didn't have a coin available, so could easily have fouled that up. Easy. Should we see what's in here? Ah, kind of think it. Could be item. Yeah, keys. I want keys. Give me keys. This should be a fairly easy room as well, so. You know, the enemies that spawn on this floor shouldn't be too much of a challenge, so it seems okay to open two chests like this to, or to fight the enemies that you get just for these chests. Great. Greatly. Well, maybe a bit more of a challenge than I anticipated, because I won't seem to stay on my creep. Although I'm producing plenty of it. Doing okay. Qualify for a deal with the devil on the last floor, which is pretty nice, because obviously as a keeper, there's no way of protecting what is considered to be your red hearts with spirit hearts. You just have to not get hit. So getting angel deals seems unlikely, unless we get completely out of control, sort of Tammy's head brimstone sort of nonsense, except of course then we'd have to get brimstone, which we can't have. I mean, we can. We found chaos in the shop, which seems likely with the number of coins that we're getting because we're not actually taking damage, which, you know, famous last words and all that, but you know what I mean. We've taken sufficiently little damage that all of our coin flips have actually let us keep the coin. Oh, that was a mistake. I think we'll be okay then. This little guy's like, get out of the way! It's like a little brother, big brother sort of thing. Ah, something caused that. Fuck. Thing to die. I got stuck on the thing and I just watched my fate. It's like, you know, I'm gonna get hit here. I will accept it. I will not try to dodge it. And then I will move on. Could get full health. We could get addicted. Could get a pretty shitty item. We did. I'm happy with it. I mean, it's probably not necessarily worth what I just did. I'm pretty happy that thing's, feared right now, because it gives us a lot less to worry about. Stay feared. There we go. Again, every time we shoot something, it gets knocked off of our creep. I think we do take Steam Sale. Nothing in that shop is necessarily that useful. But being able to make the money that we're generating on a semi-regular basis go that much further seems like a good plan. Whoa! Don't like the fact that these things also refuse to take creep damage. Simply by moving so much. Ah, you fucker. Oh, you did the coin and why did you die? Bastard. Oh, the one thing that I didn't want to happen with them was that to actually die from creep, and yet that's exactly what did happen. Well, that took me completely by surprise. I'm going to call it there. That's been 23 minutes or so. So thank you for watching. I'm going to keep pressing random even though this happens all the time because it's a nice respite from just trying to do angel rooms all the time. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly nearly did. And I hope that you will join me for the next one. But until then, good day.